Chromosomes are made up of young actively dividing cells. These cells continuously divide and cause the growth of the plant. In the Greek, the word meristos means dividable. Based on their position in the plant body, meristematic tissues are of three types. They are apical, lateral, and intercalary meristems. Apical meristems are located at or near the tips of roots and shoots. So, if we cut the tips of the roots, they will lose the meristematic tissues which are responsible for their growth. For this experiment, we need two glass jars. We need to take two glass jars and fill them with water and place two onion bulbs, one on each one. Observe the growth of roots in both onion bulbs for a few days. Glasses with water. Place the onion bulbs on each jar. And again, we will see what will happen after 24 hours. After 24 hours of the experiment, I am going to observe if there are any changes in the roots of the onion bulbs. The roots have grown a little bit. Observe the change. Now I am replacing the water with fresh water. Observe the changes that happened after one day. It's been 48 hours after we've put the onions in the water. Let's observe the changes. I think the roots have grown a little bit. Now I'm going to change the water. What will happen after 24 hours? I mean, after one day. Today we have completed 3 days after we have started the experiment. Let's see if there are any changes that occurred. Have grown a little bit longer. Let's replace the water now. After one day or 24 hours. Today we have completed 4 days as we have started the onion experiment. Let's see what changes that have occurred. completed 5 days after we have started the experiment. Let's observe the changes. There are a few changes. Now I'm cutting the tips of the roots of this onion. Now let's observe the change after 1 day. I haven't cut the roots of the onion in jar 2, but I have cut the roots of the onion in jar 1. According to the experiment, these roots should not grow. Let's see if they will grow or not.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Today is the last day of the experiment. Yesterday we have cut the tips of the roots in this jar. In this jar, we haven't cut the tips of the roots. Can you observe the difference in both the jars? Yes, the roots are shorter in this jar than this. Do you know why? Because we have cut the apical meristem. In the jar 2, we cut the tips of the roots. That's the reason the roots will stop growing. So what is the conclusion? When we cut apical meristems, when we cut the tips of the roots, the growth has stopped because we have cut the apical meristems. And the apical meristems are related to the growth. So we can say that apical meristems are responsible for the growth of the roots. And they are located at the tips of the roots. This vertical growth is called primary growth.